Andrews McMeel Publishing presents Diary of an 8-Bit Warrior, Book 4, Path of the Diamond, by Cube Kid, performed by Michael Gallagher. Saturday, afternoon. My mind was a water block in the nether. One second it was there, and then, with just a little puff of smoke, gone. Poof. A little wisp. First of all, the 5 best students would become captains, meaning they'd have their own squad to command. As if that wasn't crazy enough, Drill admitted that we might someday actually attack Herobrine's castle. How could we? I just don't get it. Everyone around me was equally flabbergasted. Silence grew into murmurs, panicked voices, and questions, questions, a whole lot of questions. The most common question being, "Mayor, sir, is it really true?" Alone upon the platform, the mayor sighed again. "Yes, it's true. It's something we've been considering, anyway. Now, if you'll all just quiet down." But they didn't quiet down. Not at all. It was madness. Madness. Total chaos. Everyone was shouting at once, swarming the platform, asking the mayor an endless stream of questions. Then an old man got so angry, he looked to the sky and started screaming at the top of his lungs. I have no idea what his problem was. Emerald said it better than I ever could, although I could barely hear her over the constant roar. Did I hear that right? Not to rain on anyone's Enderman party here, but, this is the worst news yet. Clearly Drill was talking about a different Herobrine. I mean, let's face it, there's no way he meant the Herobrine, who sends out streams of lightning like a dispenser firing arrows, turns people into rabbits with the snap of his fingers, and, oh, has entire legions of super powerful mobs under his control.
Yeah, they can't be serious about attacking, Max said. Knowing Herobrine, his castle probably doesn't even have gates or an entrance of any kind. Come to think of it, do they even know where his castle is located? I found nothing on this, even after days and days of research. He nudged me. Speaking of which, are you ready to help me crack the books tomorrow, buddy boy?
Breeze commented with as few words as possible, as usual. It's like my home village all over again. Weirdly, Stump seemed a bit happy about this news.
This means I can slack off now. I don't care if I'm a captain, as long as I'm crushing zombies with you.
Colbert, too, was rather upbeat.
You villagers don't need captains, he boomed. Path of the Diamond? How about Path of the Slain Zombies? For that is what I, Colbert of Terraria, will leave behind on my way to Herobrine's castle.
A couple other humans looked at him strangely.
Terraria?
He shrugged.
What? That's what these people call Earth, noobs.
He was telling the truth. I only use Earth because I learned that word from Steve. Another thing to consider. What if I somehow fail to become a captain? If that happens, well, knowing my luck, I'd be placed under Pebble's command. I'd have to do whatever he tells me to do. I can only imagine how well that might turn out.
Don't sulk. Carrying lava buckets is super important. You never know when the zombies could attack again, right? Hey, let's not spill it everywhere, okay?
If I thought my life at school was bad, farewell. As the crowd grew louder and louder, pressing the mayor for answers, something happened that nobody expected. Steve appeared, with Mike at his side. That wasn't so strange in itself, but they were riding horses. I hadn't talked to them in a few days. Last I'd heard, they'd been working overtime on redstone contraptions. The sight of those two, as they approached the mayor's platform riding saddled mounts, caused the crowd to quiet down.
If I may say one thing, Steve said, perhaps you should send messengers to the other villages. If you really are planning an attack in the future, you'll need all the help you can get.
The mayor nodded, gaze lowered, seemingly deep in thought, then nodded again.
An excellent plan, to be sure,
but we must assume that Herobrine's forces are everywhere. Such a long journey would be exceedingly dangerous, even on horseback.
Don't worry about us, Mike said. It's not like we've ever failed you before.
Again, the mayor nodded. Indeed, and I suspect you never will. Very well. Shall I send a guide to accompany you?
We'll manage, Steve said,
and held up a map and compass.
Count on it.
Steve was like my mentor and big brother at the same time. Now he was leaving. Maybe he found this existence too depressing and had to try to get away. However, when he rode over to me, I saw only hope in his shiny square eyes.
I don't know what's happening, Runt. Every day I wake up hoping to find that this is all a dream, just like Herobrine said. But I know it's not. We're here for a reason. I've got to help out.
But the village needs you, I said. You humans are much more creative than us. He shook his head.
You may not see it, but you're just as good as we are when it comes to defending this place. Plus, there's another reason why we're going, Mike said. They might have more knowledge about crafting. We'll try to bring back some new toys.
Toys? You mean new items? You'll give me one, right?
Well, yeah, sure, of course.
Promise?
Super promise.
Okay, deal. With that, my otherworldly friends took off. They were the ones who had shown us that the mobs could be fought. Without them, we would have suffered the same fate as so many other villages out there. I imagined the endless wilderness outside of our walls. Plains and forests and rolling hills as far as the eye can see, littered with the remnants of our kind. They'll be traveling through that for a long time. Whatever. That's their decision. 2 months ago, I would have dwelt on it, gotten angry and sad. But I'm a new me now, a future captain, hopefully. I can't be whining and raging all the time. They can go on their little adventure. Meanwhile, Team Runt will be relaxing in the coolest place in Village Town. Party at the pool. For the first time in her life, Breeze was beginning to have fun. After the celebration, we went to the pool. The mobs wouldn't be coming back anytime soon, and we totally needed a break. The builders made this area underground. It used to be a giant cavern the miners had cleared out. The main attraction is the heated water. There's a small lava pool bubbling underneath the floor that heats it perpetually. From what the humans have told me, the game version of our world doesn't simulate temperature beyond melting snow and ice. The real world isn't so forgiving. Try spending a night in a tundra biome. You'll be throwing down a furnace real quick. We changed into our swimming suits and jumped in. We agreed to play Creeper's Revenge, one of our favorite games. It's where a single cat must avoid the splashes of the many creepers as they dive in, over and over. You're probably wondering how we decide teams. After someone shouts go, the last one to call out boom is the first to be the cat. Go! Boom!
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 Breeze glanced at the three of us. Boom? She'd obviously never played this before. We all turned to Emerald.
Looks like you're the cat,
Stump said. However, Emerald didn't respond. She was still standing on the edge of the shallow side, staring absently into the water. So, an Enderman from the start, I knew it. So Breeze was happy and Emerald was sad. What next? At this rate, Herobrine will teleport into our village and give everyone milk and cookies. I swam over to her. Something bothering you?
Yeah, me.
She sat down and dipped her legs into the water.
I've been thinking, and I just can't forgive myself.
For what?
For running away. This is the second time I've chickened out.
The other three swam over as well.
Everyone ran yesterday.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.